Hey everyone, it's Norm from Tested. Happy Friday, and I have a quick show and tell for you today. It is another exploration in LED lighting, but it's super simple, no big project, but it is a really, really cool piece of kit. This was brought to our attention via our friends at Adafruit, who also learned about this from maker and YouTuber Naomi Wu, and I've been really curious about this for a long time. So you've seen it in the thumbnail and the YouTube description. We're talking about wireless LED lights. It's a thing that actually works and exists. A couple of years ago, there was a company called Xbase out of Japan that ran a Kickstarter campaign, and the promise was that they would have a display stand that you could put maybe your Gundam models or your small figurines, and you can light them up with these tiny LED lights that would not need to actually be wired. They would be powered through inductive charging, through the same basic fundamental technology as the kind of wireless, you know, contact-based chargers that you would have charging a Qi charger on your smartphone and other technologies out there. It's been around for a long time. Fundamentally, we're talking about, you know, two coils, copper coils, a primary coil and a secondary coil. There's an electromagnetic field generated, and in that volume, you can actually transfer some current from AC over to DC. And Adafruit has started stocking up on two versions of a kit, and I was able to get the small version. So that's what we have here. For $15, what you get is this coil with a little bit of circuit board here. It's 5 volts, so we're gonna plug this in to our handy USB power supply. And then it also comes with an assortment of these wireless LEDs. Very, very basic. This is their small coil, which is about 3 inches in diameter. So we're talking about in terms of millimeters. What is this? Got our handy calipers out here. 70 millimeters in diameter. There's also one that's much larger at 10 inches in diameter. And the larger the coil, the bigger the volume, the field that's generated. So the more options you have in placing these LED lights. But let's get a quick demonstration to see how this works. So we're gonna go plug this in. I'm gonna first make sure I adjust my USB power supply to 5 volts right here. And then we're just gonna make sure our leads are connected. You could, of course, use any power supply of your choice as long as you have the right voltage here. So 5 volts works just fine out of this USB port. And we got our positive and negative leads. So we're gonna put this off the side here and have a good view of the coil again, about 3 inches. And you can already tell there's a little bit of light happening on this, this LED. I'm gonna get these out of the baggie. They are rather tiny and delicate and fragile. So very easy to lose as well. So I've actually had to pick a few off the floor, but there you go, wow. They've lit up immediately. There are 10 that come with a pack in a wide range of colors. So you have blue, red, green, yellow, and white. And we'll just put them right in the center here. Gotta be careful not to lose them. But I'll put them in here. And what I'll do is I'll turn off the lamp so you can see how bright these are and how they're lit. A couple interesting things. So the orientation of the coils here actually has an effect on how strong the light is. I'm gonna pop these all so they're facing up. And you can see the ones that are on their side, not so much. They really prefer to be pointed up and down. And then we'll pick one up and move it around so you can get a sense of the volume and where that field is. At about this 3-inch diameter, you're only going to get about a couple inches above or below this coil for operating light. And as I move this white light around, you can see it starts losing some of that power. It's still lit up here. That's about 3 inches. And if I'm directly above it, yes, but it's basically very dim at this point and loses power right around there. So that's actually not so bad. That's about 4 inches before it really loses all its power. And then outside of the coil, you can't really go much outside. So yeah, not really. There's a little bit right there. It's not bad, not bad. Yeah, so you get maybe a couple inches outside that circumference. And it really is strongest right above this kind of cylinder area. Even in the center, it's actually pretty good. If I rotate it, so off axis, you can see that it's actually dimming slightly. I don't know if you can notice that. I see it with my eye. It's dimming slightly as I turn it 90 degrees, but still operating. And if I set this down, I can move the coil itself. You can see it actually still operates when they're underneath the coil around that same distance as well. So you start losing power once the coil is a little, about 4 inches away. And so you're really anchored to the this diameter here, and this is circumference, or the volume around, above, and below that coil. And we'll do one more demonstration, one more test. If I put a couple of these on some acrylic, again, oh, they just want to roll around. It does transfer the power through, let's say, 2 sheets of acrylic, yeah, through material, no problem. And that's kind of the magic of this, that these little lights don't need to be physically wired to any power. It's just running it through that EM field. And if you can hide the coil, that primary coil, underneath some type of display or embedded in something, there's a lot of interesting opportunity to have a diorama display within, of course, the limitations of this volume here. The larger coil, at 10 inches, gives you a height of about 6 inches above it, where you can activate the lights. So it's not that much more, but I still think more meaningful than this 3-inch coil. And one of the neat things, if you take a look at these lights, and maybe I'll give you a little bit more illumination, we'll zoom in just a bit so you can just see exactly how these look and exactly how tiny they are. Let me get one of this green one right here. So you can see there's a light here and then a tiny copper coil underneath it. And we're talking about the whole thing is about 4.78 millimeters tall and with a diameter of under 4.6 millimeters. So under 5 millimeters, which is really, really tiny. And when you think about places you can potentially put this, these lights, one of them that came to mind is Lego. And so I've brought out my Lego Ideas Ecto-1 that we put together a couple years ago. And if you look at like a headlamp here, we'll take one of these blue LEDs. It actually does fit very nicely into the cavity of a Lego, a hollow Lego stud, with plenty of room on either side. And you can affix them maybe with, you know, something like glue dots. So we can grab these little glue pads, very handy, tiny adhesives. place it in here. And kind of fit that in. And you can tell it's giving a little bit of illumination there. Yeah, you're really limited by kind of the size of the coil and that working volume. And unfortunately, the larger 10-inch one is out of stock. These things are selling as soon as Adafruit can stock them. But I'll include links in the description below so you can get an email notification whenever they do become in stock. But for $15, getting 10 of these wireless LEDs and a coil to mess around with is just a lot of fun and a great deal. You can look on eBay, and I think the X-Base Kickstarter, they sell, I believe, compatible LEDs. A little pricey, I think like $2 per LED is the cheapest I've been able to find them. You can buy a 10-pack sometimes for like $30 in a variety of colors. And that's something I hope Adafruit gets a chance to stock in the future, buying extra packs of just these diodes. So you have one coil and have a lot of options for lighting. But just to have fun and get started, a coil, 10 lights, $15. It actually works and almost works like a little bit of a magic trick. But it's, of course, it's science, it's physics, and it's a lot of fun. So go check it out and hope you enjoyed this little show and tell. Have a wonderful weekend, and we'll be back next time with more lighting and diorama projects. I'm Norm, and I'll see you next time. Bye.